Hi, good afternoon, good morning, everybody. Welcome to our channel. My name is Princess, and wherever you are in the world, we're very happy to have you on this channel. If you're new here, this is a channel that where we talk about how to marry in the Lord, how to marry a Christian, how to find the right partner, whom to spend the rest of your life with, how to pray, and we give advice and little tips about relationship and how Christians particularly need to go about finding the right partner and building happy homes eventually. That's our objective. I am a mentor, an advisor, your friend, and your sister. And so today I'm going to talk quickly and briefly about when you meet the right one. Okay, so what are the things that you should see? What are the things that you would expect when you meet the right one? Is it just as soon as you meet him, hula bula, everything is just fine, it's perfect, and how do you know that you've met the right one? And how do you know when you have met the right one? Those are some of the questions that we've been getting from a lot of our viewers, a lot of our group members, because we actually have a group on Facebook which is called DLBC Singles, so Divine Bible Church Singles. We're going to put the link in the description section below, and we have a page also. We also have an Instagram page. If you're not part of these ones, these groups, these social media handles, you're very welcome to follow us on Instagram, to join the group on Facebook where we have discussions and conversations about relationship questions that are burning in the hearts of young people. And some of those things we have for you to use to make you better, you know, to answer your questions and all of that. So do well to join this, all these social media handles, and you'll be happy that you did. So just jump back in. I just need to talk to you from my heart and to tell you what I think, you know, from my own experience, and this is what I would like to bring here. So first, when you find the right person, you need a lot of patience. Now, patience is a virtue. That's what we always hear being said. Patience is a virtue. So you need a lot of patience when you find the right person, okay? You don't need to be in a hurry. Sometimes it takes a long time before the person decides that yes, you are the right person for them, or they want to take the step further and, you know, do the right thing. Some people have known that you are the person they want to get married to, but they are taking their time, you know, they're taking their time, taking slow steps, because they don't want to make mistakes. Some people have made mistakes and they find it difficult to trust. And so you need a lot of patience. If you are a man, so a male, you know that women who have been hurt before, you need a lot of patience with them because of what their past experiences are. They find it difficult to trust again. They find it difficult to love with all of their hearts. You know, it's a learning process. It's a learning curve. They get to that point where they grow into, you know, opening their hearts again to another person after being hurt, and really asking themselves a lot of questions. And they'll ask you a lot of questions because they're doubting you. It doesn't mean that you're not a good person. It doesn't mean that you're seeing the wrong things, especially when your heart is right and you really want to do right by them. But just be patient with them, answer their questions. And as a woman as well, answer the questions of this man. Be yourself, be natural, be very patient. Don't be pushy, don't be, you know, don't be, you know, so imposing, but be patient, be soft, let your femininity be obvious, you know, just be a woman and be patient. Secondly, you may have doubt at some point in your journey, you know, and this sometimes I'm talking from a lot of experience, and so many people have shared with me that this is some of the things that they also experience. You might have some doubts at some point in your relationship journey. When you cross that line, you will be so sure. You know, when you cross the line of doubt and you come to a point where you begin to trust this person, and when you come to a point when you have made your peace and you have this peace in your mind, unshakable, unmovable peace, that you are with the right person, you'll be so sure. Okay, so don't be surprised, don't be embarrassed, or don't be shocked that you have some doubt at some point, you know, just let things go through and keep praying. As Christians, I advise people to keep praying. So keep praying, keep asking the Lord, reading the Word of God, taking advice from matured Christians, and keep your pastor informed about everything that you're doing. So even when you experience some kind of doubt, even in our church, you know, during your courtship relationship, there are times when some things will happen and you begin to doubt, am I really in the right relationship? Am I doing the right thing? This is a lifetime commitment. Am I doing it right? Is this the final bus stop for me? You know, you go through those things, but don't worry. When you cross that line, you would know when you finally made your decision and you're sure that this is the person that you want to spend the rest of your life with. You'll be so sure when you have crossed that line. Trust me. You'll be so sure you have crossed that line. You may struggle with God's will. Okay? I'm going to be very, very sincere with you. Some people have struggled with God's will. And that's because what they thought, you know, what they expected was different from what they got, you know. Some people want some kind of man, for him to have some kind of look. Some men want a kind of woman, you know, with a certain height, a certain shape, a certain, you know, look, whatever it is. But God might have something different. The Bible said in that my thoughts are not your thoughts. God has better thoughts for us. And sometimes God's thought doesn't look as perfect, but God has a perfect time. God has a perfect one for us. So God's will, you might struggle with it, you know, because your human heart, your human heart wants to fight with God's will. As human beings, you know, we always want to strive with God. You know, God said he doesn't want to continually strive with men. You know, that's, you know, God was tired. God noticed that this man that he has created, this human being that he has created, always puts him in a situation where he has to strive. He has to, you know, there's this struggle between man and God. The human heart wants to go its own way. And that's why when God shows you his will, you want to do your own. You're like, oh no, maybe is it the right thing and all that. But don't struggle with God, you know. Don't let your human heart get the better part of you. But leave yourself in the hands of God. And when you find yourself struggling, go back to the Lord in prayer and say, Lord, I'm struggling with your will, and help me to do your will. I want to do your will. I want to marry the person that you have for me. I want to do what will make you happy. And I want you, I want you to be in the center of it all. So don't struggle with God. You know, when your heart is struggling, commit it to the Lord and be willing to bend to do God's will. Just do his will, no matter what it is, no matter what you see. Once it's God that's leading you and you're sure that God is leading you, my brother, my sister, I want to advise that you let yourself in the hands of God.